And with the Arushi murder case taking a U-turn, the apex court will hear Nupur Talwar's review petition today. This comes just after the CBI tore into the review petition accusing her of bench hunting. Nupur Talwar had earlier sought a Supreme Court verdict review that upheld a lower court direction, summoning her and her husband to stand trial. And we have Meenakshi reporting on the story. Meenakshi, what can we expect now that the CBI has actually slammed Nupur Talwar and torn into her review petition?
Well, this is a very crucial hearing which is scheduled to take place in around 2 p.m. in the afternoon. What we are looking at essentially is that CBI, we know the averments that it has made before the top court. It has made several startling allegations for the first time perhaps against Nupur Talwar. How much resonance it finds with the top court remains to be seen. What is also very interesting is the fact that the CBI has tried to highlight the fact that review law in India makes it abundantly clear that Nupur's plea does not warrant consideration of review, because it is the Supreme Court in the rarest of rare cases that the Supreme Court allows an open court hearing in the review. Let me give you a quick list of cases wherein the court disposed of these matters in court, be that the Vodafone taxation case or the telecom cancellation of licenses or even the PMO review. Review law in India is very specific. Only those facts which have not yet been considered by the court and after they come into light and if they have any significance on the outcome of the case, only in that scenario, in the rarest of rare scenario, we have the Supreme Court judging its own judgment. CBI, on the other hand, is also trying to convince the apex court of Nupur's conduct. They're saying this is just a ploy employed by her and her counsels to circumvent the system. They have gone on record to state this, and this is extremely interesting, that Nupur is trying to take advantage of the new judge on the bench. Now, this is very crucial here. Honorable Justice Keher has been a part of the bench which permitted the trial of Talwar's to commence as accused. Justice Ganguly, now retired, and Honorable Justice Keher were a part of that bench, and Justice Keher was also a part of the bench which allowed the transfer plea, which dismissed Nupur's transfer plea, wherein she was pleading that her matter be transferred from Ghaziabad to Delhi. So essentially, Justice Keher is defending his own two judgments, as he is again seized of the matter, because this particular bench comprises Justice Patnaik and Justice Keher, wherein they will decide on various aspects of the review. Nupur, on the other hand, is pleading before the judge pertaining to certain aspects of the case which really should be considered at the trial stage. That is the argument the CBI is making. So extremely crucial hearing, very interesting sequence of events, and we will bring more to you, and it will be all eyes on Supreme Court to see how the Honorable Bench decides, given the fact that Justice Keher himself has been a part of the two earlier judgments where Nupur's plea have been dismissed, and he is defending his two judgments this time around. Back
right,
to you.
So Meenakshi, how do you assess Nupur Talwar's situation at the moment, now that she's being slammed by the CBI, and also this is now considered as one of the rarest of the rare cases, and even the Supreme Court not taking very kindly to the sequence of events that have happened over the last few weeks? How is her position at this point, considering she's had the best legal brains trying to defend her case?
Well, the situation at best can be described as difficult. There is no doubt that the heat is on Nupur Talwar. That is the reason we have seen her counsels go on record several times and blame the media for the sharp scrutiny that she has been subjected to. On one hand, they blame the media, and on the other hand, they try and cite the incident that happened in 2008, wherein they again cite media reports to showcase the fact that the Talwars have been grieving parents. So really, it's a lot of double speak that we are seeing emanate from the Talwar camp. But one fact is certain, that Nupur has to really leave no stone unturned to convince the top court as to why her review deserves a reconsideration, because this is the Supreme Court judging its own judgment, its own January order, wherein Justice Keher and Justice Ganguly permitted the trial to commence against Talwars as accused. So this time around, the pressure is on the Talwars to to convince the court as to what new aspects they have which can really overturn an earlier ruling of the same court. Alongside, the CBI has also reiterated the fact that a trial court, a competent trial court in Ghaziabad, is seized of the matter, and the conduct of Nupur Talwar has shown itself on record when time and again she has disregarded the summons placed before issued by the trial court and not appeared really in the Ghaziabad court. What is also very interesting is on the 18th of April, the trial court itself made an observation as to how did it lie in the mouth of CBI to give an assurance before the top court when the matter of NBW was pending before it. So difficult position of Nupur Talwar at best.
All right, many thanks, Meenakshi, for those details.